Okay, today we are tying stimulators. Stimulators are a lot of fun. They're a fly that catches fish, but they're also a challenge if you have a little experience tying some flies. These take some practice, definitely, because we are trying to apply a lot of materials to that small area of that hook. You know, as you can see, we have two sets of elk hair that we're going to tie in, a tail and a wing, dubbing twice. We've got hackle twice. So learning the proportions and kind of the techniques to make this a little easier and make a good looking fly will take some practice, but hopefully I can help you out with this video. And the first thing we're going to do is tie on a tail. So again, we want that tail to come out just above the barb of the hook, but I'm not going to tie that elk hair right in there. Let's just bring our thread back about to the halfway point. And this is where I'm going to clip off some elk hair. And this can be kind of tricky trying to figure out exactly how much to get. I usually, as kind of a rule here, as I clip this elk hair from its hide, I like to just take my scissors and come along and get about a scissor full amount for the wing. That would be about the right amount for like a caddis or a stimulator. But for this tail, I'm going to use about half. I'm going to snip that off right there. So let me get some and snip it off. Okay, now it's a little messy there. So I've got the tip sections and the butt. You can see there's a lot of under fur there. I like to just comb that out. I got this handy little comb here just to comb out some of that fuzz. If you don't, you can just use your fingers and just get rid of that. Now we're going to use our hair stacker. Hopefully you have a hair stacker. Now to take the hair out, I'm going to just turn it sideways. Here's the bottom part of the hair stacker, and just carefully slide the bottom half off, and hopefully our hair is in there nice and stacked up. I got a few strays there, but let's gather those. Okay, so now I've got the hair, so kind of a nice little paintbrush looking deal there. If you have some that have some broken tips or whatever, we can try to get rid of those. And I want the tail to extend just over the bend of the hook there. So once I have that marked, I'm just going to switch it to my left hand. Now notice my thread is up there a little ways. Let's just gather all that with one loose wrap and add a little tension. You can see those butts will flare. Now I'm going to tie down this hair as I hold on with my left hand. I'll just slide my fingers back and tie that in. What I'm creating is a nice even underbody to this fly. I'm kind of creating that underbody, and there I am just above the barb of the hook. And let's come right back down. That elk hair should kind of collapse neatly. I don't want to bulk it up too much. So, okay, now we can trim all these butts off here. Let's hold that straight up. And I just need a piece that's 3 or 4 inches long. And again, I've relocated my thread up there towards just past halfway. And let's just hold that wire along the side of the hook there. And we will tie that down back to the back. So we've kind of created a nice little taper build there. Now we can dub the body forward. Got some purple dubbing here, and we're going to just dub this on very carefully, just basically trying to coat that orange thread and put a little purple body on there. Okay, and our thread should end up at that 2/3 position. Now we're ready for some hackle. I just have some brown whiting saddle hackle here. We're just going to, and I've kind of pre-sized these a little bit. You know, you don't want too large a hackle. I just measure the barb so they extend maybe just past the point of the hook or the hook gap there. And we'll carefully secure that piece of hackle right there at that 2/3 position, and take our thread right back to that spot. Now we can wind this hackle back towards the back, and we'll just carefully make nice even wraps as we approach the back end of the fly there. Remember, we have our wire there waiting for us. I'm going to come around and tie that down opposite, make one good turn right at the back, and then we'll just carefully counter wrap that going forward. If you need to kind of wiggle through some of those hackle barbs, try not to really mash them down, hopefully, or catch any of them. And that'll make that fly a lot more durable. Okay, once we reach the front, make a good turn there, and we'll hold out with our right hand, drop our thread over about three times, like that. Add a little thread tension, and then you can spiral wrap that off. Okay, and this hackle the back, that should just pop off right there. All right, very good. Now, if we've got a little messy up there, that's no problem. Let's just kind of make a few good turns and make sure our thread is right back at that 2/3 spot. Now we're ready to work on the wing and the thorax. So we want to be careful. If we're up in this area, it's going to be very difficult. So let's get us another set of some more elk hair. So I'm just going to clip off another set of elk hair. And again, I'm going to try to get about a full first row, full scissor amount there. We'll clip that off. And again, we'll repeat the steps there, kind of clean off. Lost my brush. Oh, there it is. Some of that under fur, it'll stack a lot neater, cleaner. Hopefully we've got some good straight elk hair. This stuff looks pretty good. Let's stack it up. Okay, that's pretty good. Now, I want to measure the tips of the tail and the wing together. So once I have that measurement, I can switch it to my left hand. And this is the tricky part, because if you got too much elk, it becomes a little bit of a problem. If you don't have enough, it looks a little naked. So I'm just going to make two or three really good turns there like that before I let go with my left hand. And let's just bring those tips up. And you want good sharp scissors, which I don't have. Dull. Let's get a different pair. And we'll try to trim that up as close as I can down there. Now notice, I don't really like to trim just straight off, because I don't really want a cliff there. I'm going to try to actually build a thread taper there. So just come back, pinch your elk hair right there, and then let's come down and tie down those butts really good and give it some really good tight wraps and build a little thread base. You're gonna have a few whiskers sticking out there, but if I make a few good turns there, it's building me a taper back down to the eye of the hook. Let's just come up the wing just slightly. Okay, there we go, like so. So there's the wing. Now, an option we can put some rubber legs on this. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to put a set of rubber legs, but before I put the rubber legs in, let's put in our hackle for the front. So I'm going to use Grizzly. Again, I've tried to pre-size this a little bit and make sure I've get If the hackle in the front's a little larger than the hackle in the back, that's good. I like that. And we'll prepare this. Let's let's get the stem there, and we're gonna just tie that in along the side there. And we'll secure that stem down right in there. Again, bring our thread right back to that 2/3 spot. All right, now we'll take our rubber legs. I've got some purple rubber legs to kind of match. I'm going to go just on the underside of that hackle right there and just give it a couple good tight turns like that. And we'll repeat that on the opposite side. Two good turns. Let's give it three. Okay, and now we'll use some dubbing. I've got some kind of amber color dubbing for the thorax. Again, that combination is your choice. The textbook has kind of this amber, so we'll dub this. And again, not too much. I'm just basically covering up that real bright thread. All right, now I got to dub through a lot here. So let's just pull the back legs back and let's just make a couple of turns in between the legs there, and then we'll pull the front legs back and come up underneath those and dub just up in front. Let's add a little more dubbing as we go here. Try not to get too greedy. I think this should be about the right amount. Again, pull those legs back out of the way and we'll just follow that taper that we've already built down to the eye of the hook, and we can start building our head there, clean head. All right, now we've got our grizzly hackle. Let's bring that straight up. And we'll come, try to avoid that elk hair. Let's come right between those legs with one good turn right there. And now we can pull these legs back and come just in front. And I'm spacing this hackle out just slightly so I can still see some of that amber dubbing. Do one last turn right here. And then we will hold that hackle straight up in the air and drop our thread over to capture that and tie that down about three times. And try not to crowd our head or get that hackle up into the eye of the hook. You've probably had experience with that. If you do have a few whiskers, let's just pull everything back and just make a few turns to cover up any imperfections and put a nice clean head on there. Oh, sorry, little focus issue there. And now we can whip finish. Ah, rubber legs up in my face. Snip off that. And we'll trim the legs to how we like them. And add a little head cement, and we're off and rolling. And what you have is a great summertime fly.